Hi guys, welcome back to this channel. If you're new here, my name is Jeniffer, and by the title you can see I am getting a boob job, also known as getting breast implants. So honestly, I didn't know if I should do a video or not. I was really scared of being judged by others, but I sat there and I thought about it, and why should I live my life for others? I shouldn't be afraid to do something just because I'm gonna get judged by others. I should do what makes me happy. So I definitely want to put out a video, just because when I was deciding if I wanted one, all I did was watch other people's YouTube videos, their TikToks. I researched as much as I could. So if I could help another girl out there who is in the same boat as me, wants to do this, then this is who the video is for. If you are judgmental or you do not approve, you do not have to watch this video. But if you're gonna stay, I'm happy you are here, and I'm excited to tell you all about it. So first I'm gonna tell you why I wanted to get it, the whole research process, how much it costs. So let's jump into it. First, I wanted to get it because I feel like ever since I went through puberty, ever since I was growing up, I always noticed that I was on the smaller side, and it hasn't really bothered me too much. I kind of always knew that I was petite. I honestly always thought that they would get bigger, so I've always said to myself, oh, they'll get bigger. I went on birth control thinking that they were going to get bigger, and birth control had no effect on me whatsoever. I stayed the same, so that was out of the question. Then I kept telling myself, oh, I'm gonna have kids. Well, here I am, 28 years old, no kids yet, have no idea when that's gonna happen. So I want to do this for me right now. I feel like I am mature in my life. I'm 28, so I didn't decide this when I was younger, which who knows what size I would have decided then. I feel like I'm mature, I have my head on my shoulders, I know exactly what I want. I'm not doing this for anyone else, I'm doing this for me. My main reason why is because bikinis. I feel like I don't mind how I look in shirts, like that's whatever, but when I wear a bikini, that's what I see. I see that they're so small, I can't fill out my bikinis. Sometimes when I'm at the pool and I lean over, you can see underneath because I don't fill out anything, so I'm like flashing when I go places because my bikini top isn't filled out. So that's concerning. I feel like I always look down and I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm flashing because I don't have enough to fill in the shirt, the bikini, whatever I'm wearing. I've noticed that happening multiple times. So I am going to go on the smaller side. CC's confused me the most when I was going through this process, but 200 is really small. I don't think 200 you'd be able to tell a difference. Maybe a little bit in bikinis, but I'm going with, I think, 250. So I tried on sizers 200, 250, 300, 350. The 300 I thought was way too big, so I didn't even like the 350. The 200 I tried it on and I did like it, but like I said, it was very small. I'm not sure if it would give me the look that I want in the bikini, so I think I'm deciding on 250, which I think is perfect for me. I'm still gonna look petite. You probably won't even know that I have it done in regular shirts, maybe a little, but in bikinis is where I'm really wanting the look, because that's what bothers me the most. So do your research, really look at the surgeons in your area, read their reviews. That's what I did the most. I read reviews. If I seen any review that I was like, oh, that's kind of weird, no, don't go with them. I seen two surgeons. The first one, I liked his work, he had good reviews, but I just felt not right in his office. I felt like he did not take his time with me. I felt very rushed. I felt very confused and unsure when I left his office, and you should never feel like that. So I went and seen my second surgeon, totally different experience. I left out of there wanting it that second, signed the paperwork, booked it, I was good to go. They answered all of my questions, they made me feel so sure in what I wanted. So I walked out of there feeling so happy, so ready. So now I am prepping and I am doing everything holistically. So in this video, you will see everything I am doing to prep for my surgery, what I've gotten, what I've been doing. So let's jump right into it. I am on the way to the pre-op appointment, which is where I decide on the size I want to get, and we go over medicine that I need to pick up before the surgery, other things I need to do to prepare for the surgery, and I think I'm gonna get a list of items of things I need to get for after the surgery. But today I am mostly really nervous about the size because I am very confused on the size that I want. I'm thinking 235cc to 285cc, but I feel like I should just be safe and go in the middle. But I'm going to talk about that with them today and see what they recommend. I have different wish pictures that I want to show them, but overall I'm very confused. We're pulling into the parking garage now, so I will keep you guys updated with the size that I decide. I am at the pre-op, about to try on sizers. I just got home from my pre-op appointment. I got to try on the sizers again, and this time I tried on 200 just to see what the 200 would look like. I actually really liked the look of the 200 and the 250, so I think I'm gonna tell him whatever would fit my wish pictures the best out of those, he can decide. I feel like I'm gonna end up getting 250 and 270 or 275, hearing what the nurse had to say, but I'm still gonna tell him that I like the 200 and the 250. So whatever he decides, he knows what will look best from the wish pictures. So I'm gonna stop thinking about it so much. I feel like every single day I've been looking at pictures, but I just sent the nurse my final wish pictures. So on surgery day, he will look at the pictures, go over them with me again, and then when I go under, he'll put them in and look to see which one looks the best on my frame and that looks like my wish pictures. All that is done. Now today I need to go get blood work done to make sure that I am healthy and okay for surgery, and then I have to go pick up all my medications, and it's a lot. They're all mostly liquid since I can't swallow pills, so that'll be a little easier on me. There was only two that weren't liquid, so that's not as bad as I thought it would be, but I don't have insurance, so we're gonna see how much all this medication cost, and I will keep you guys updated. I just finished getting my blood taken. I usually always faint, but this time I did good. We ate lunch before, so I think that helped a lot. I just got a shot right here. They took 3 tubes of blood for different panels. I'm not sure exactly what the panels were for, but I think I'll get the email and find out. But they sent it over to my doctor to make sure I am in good health. So we got that done. Now we are going to go to the mall. Jacob has a few things to get since I got him a gift card, and then I'm probably gonna buy myself a pair of sweatpants for surgery just to feel cute going into surgery. So that is what we're doing now. I just got done with the mall. Lululemon was insane per usual, but the day after Christmas, it was so hectic. I just wanted a pair of sweatpants. I tried on so many. They all fit me so weird. I finally found a pair. It was in between a size 0 and 4. Of course, they did not have size 2, which is my size. The 0 was too small and the 4 was a little big, but I think you can go a little big in sweats and it doesn't look bad, so I honestly did not want to go to another store, so I just got the 4. It's a little loose, which is perfect for my surgery anyways. They want you to wear really loose clothing so they can dress you easy. I just got a pair of the Scuba HR joggers in a size 4. They're just a dark blue color. I like them. I will wear these to run errands or to lounge around with, but I'm definitely going to wear them on my surgery day, and you also have to wear a button-up shirt. I already have a button-up shirt. Just gonna wear these, and they also said to wear tennis shoes, just really easy clothing, because they will have to dress you since I'm having anesthesia and I will be out of it, so they need to dress me easy, and then I need to be able to undress myself easy after, because you can't really lift or move your arms or lift up or anything like that. But I will have Jacob there to help me undress after my surgery. He took the day of my surgery off so he could help me. Now I just need to pick up my medication. They just emailed me and said all of them are ready except for one. One is out of stock, and of course without insurance, all of this medicine is going to gonna be $500 to $600. If you're doing this without insurance, just leave some extra room in there for all the medicine you're gonna have to get. It's a lot and it's expensive. It is now a week before surgery. I got my blood panels back. The blood panels all showed that I was good and normal except for one. One of them I had was low and it was the protein. So all this week I am going to try to eat as much protein as I can. I am vegan and I only weigh 105 pounds. So for me, it is honestly hard to get all my protein in, but I'm gonna go grocery shopping and I'm going to stock up on all the protein that I can. I will say that I probably knew the protein was low just by the things I eat. I really eat whole foods and not enough protein. So I'm really gonna try to change that because in the recovery process, you need a lot of protein. So besides that, I have to go get my medication today. All of them are in at Walgreens except for one. That one says it's delayed and out of stock. So I'm kind of concerned about that. I'm gonna ask them when they think it's gonna come in because I am only a week away from my surgery. So I'm gonna pick up all the rest of them. I will let you guys know the price. I think today is gonna be around $500. And then when I pick up the other medicine, it'll be $600. So like I said in the last clip, definitely keep that in mind if you're doing this all out of pocket, that the medication is pricey. If you can get on insurance before you get the procedure, I would definitely do that. If I would have known how much it was, I probably would have gotten health insurance before, but it is okay. I saved up a lot, so I definitely have the money. I'm not worried about it. I also need to get extra strength Tylenol. I also got all my Amazon packages in, so when I come back from Walgreens, I'm gonna open up my packages and show you what I got. I got a lot of holistic stuff to detox. This whole week, I am going to be detoxing. I've already started a celery cleanse, so I've been drinking celery every single day. I started it last week, so this is my second week doing the celery. I have also cut out birth control. You have to cut out vitamin E, vitamin K, multivitamins, and omegas, so I had to cut all of that out. So I picked up some extra superfoods that I'm going to put in my smoothie, but when I get back from Walgreens, I will open it all up and show you guys what I got. I have some amazing news. When I went to Walgreens, they didn't have one of my prescriptions in stock, so the lady went over to the side and was doing a bunch of stuff, and I was waiting there for a while, and then she looks at me and she was like, oh, I'm just adding coupons to your medicine. And I was like, oh wow, thank you so much. I didn't even know they could add coupons. I didn't think it was going to be that much off, but it literally rang out to like $110, $120. I got some extra stuff, so I'm not sure what the exact price was, but it was supposed to be $500 and she got it down to $100 something. Thank you to Walgreens. I thought I was gonna spend so much out of pocket, and then it came out to that. Me not having insurance, it didn't even matter. So if you go to Walgreens and no insurance, ask them to look up some coupons for you, because that was just amazing. But I want to show you the medicine I got and what it is for. I have an issue swallowing pills, so everything is basically in liquid form. So this is a nerve pain for after surgery. They say that you might have some muscle spasms or zingers. It'll just feel weird in your nerves because your nerves are going to be messed up after surgery. This is an antibiotic to make sure that nothing gets infected. I have two more bottles in the fridge. This one is a painkiller for extreme pain. So it's a small little bottle. They don't want you using too much. This is only if I have severe pain. For the first couple days, I'll probably be taking this. And then after that, I got some extra strength Tylenol. This is what you're supposed to continue using whenever you don't need the painkillers anymore. These two are for nausea because anesthesia causes some people to be nauseous, and I always get very nauseous just in general. And then especially with what's going on, all the medicine, you're gonna be constipated. This is for after surgery. These dissolve, and then this I take before surgery because I have heard lots of people throw up after surgery, so we're going to try to prevent that. Next, I want to talk about breast implant illness. Breast implant illness is a real thing. Tons of people have gotten it. The surgeons say it's true. The issue with it is people don't know why they're getting it. The surgeons cannot say exactly what causes it. There's not enough studies on it, So for right now, no one knows where it comes from or why. Something happens to where when you get implants, some people get really sick. It might not happen right away, or it could happen years later, but it is a chance. For me, this was the number one thing that was scaring me away from getting my surgery. I honestly at first did not want to do the surgery because I was so afraid of getting sick. But lots of people don't get sick. I tried to find as much research as I could, and I came across a girl who's very holistic. She posted her research on TikTok. She's gotten implants. She's done all of the work to stay as healthy as she possibly can be pre and after surgery. She says that when you have so much toxins in your life and you're putting so much toxins in your body, you get toxic overload. So say that you're eating all this toxic food, you're always around toxic chemicals, you put toxic things on your body, your body's already at the toxic overload, then you put implants in and your body just freaks out. You start swelling up, you get rashes, some people get fatigue, brain fog, joint pain, a lot of different things, and doctors don't know where it's coming from because you cannot test for breast implant illness. I have been living a very clean, healthy life for the past 2 years, so I'm not super concerned about this. But ways to help you: don't buy those cheap candles from Walmart, from wherever else. You're gonna wanna buy soy candles. Candles that have fragrance in it are very toxic, along with the plug-ins, the air wicks, any of that. Perfumes are really toxic. Just make sure you're getting rid of everything with a fragrance. Your body wash, your hair care, your skincare, all of that. You really need to do this research before you even consider having breast implants in your body. You need to clear out all of the toxins. You need to be looking at the ingredients and making sure that there's no fragrance in anything. Fragrance is just a chemical, and it goes into your body through the candles, skincare, hair care, all of that. Anything that goes on your skin can go on your body. You can inhale it. So really stay away from fragrance. Second, your food. Seed oils, so inflammatory. Stay away from seed oils. You need to look at the ingredients. Seed oils are almost in everything. Now, to make sure you're getting all those toxins out of your body, you need a detox. And for the past 2 weeks, I said I've been doing the celery cleanse. That helps to detox. This week, I'm going even harder with my detox, and this is what I got from Amazon. Spirulina powder is really good for detoxing. You can drink this in your water. You can put it in smoothies. I'm going to be drinking this every single day leading up to my surgery, along with barley grass juice powder. This also helps to detox. Both of these are so good. I am starting these a little late. They took a while to come in from Amazon because of the holidays. I would start doing all this stuff a month before. Really get your body ready to detox. Another thing you can do to pull out the toxins out of your body is use clay. This is the bentonite clay. Sorry if I said that wrong, but you take baths in this clay and it pulls out all of the toxins. You can put it on your face, all over your body. So I will be taking a bath with this every single day to try to pull out all of the toxins that are in my body. Another way to really get your body ready, clean, detoxed, is to dry brush. I have not done this before, so this is new for me, so I need to learn how to use this, but I assume you just brush onto your body, and I will also be doing this every single day. Another way that you can get your body ready for implants is massages. I have scheduled 2 lymphatic massages. One is tomorrow, and my next one is 2 days before surgery. I would try to do them every week leading up into your surgery, but 2 is very helpful. More than that will be even better. Those are some ways that you can detox and get ready. Like I said, I want to do the most I can do to try to prevent breast implant illness. Now, once you have implants, you need to continue this lifestyle. It needs to be a complete lifestyle change. You need to be the healthiest that you can absolutely be now that you have these implants in you. That is what I will say on that. I am not a doctor, so none of this is coming from a doctor's mouth. This is just what I've researched, what other girls have researched, and I hope it helps you too. It is now the next day. I am about to head out the door and go to my lymphatic massage. I will definitely update you guys and tell you what they do. I think it's honestly just a breast massage. It's supposed to open up your lymph nodes and get everything toxic out of there. I am wearing no makeup because I'm not sure if they do anything to your face or not. So I will see and I will know for the next one. But I'm excited to go get pampered and relaxed before the surgery. I just finished my lymphatic massage, so I wanted to tell you guys what they did. It's really different than a normal massage, but they do certain movements on your face, your neck, your arms, your legs, and your stomach. They press on your lymph nodes, get it moving. They said that I could have some stomach gurgling going on or feeling like I need to swallow a lot, and it was crazy. I knew it started working when I kept feeling like I had to swallow, and then my stomach made the loudest noises ever. At first I was like, holy crap, but then it got so loud that I had to laugh because I was like, this is insane. I could really tell that it was working. Everyone was so nice there. They explained to me what was going on. So your lymph nodes can be backed up and they hold a lot of toxins. When you press on them and get them moving, it gets you able to flush them out. So they said I need to drink a lot of water after to flush them all out. And they also gave me a goodie bag, which is so sweet. The whole entire staff was so nice. They gave me tea when I got there. I felt super comfortable. They gave me a pamphlet and she said the next time I come, she will do red light therapy for free on me. This just shows what red light therapy does. And then they gave me some little snacks. I'm gonna eat this now because I feel hungry. And then I thought this was so cool. They gave me a dry brush and I just ordered one of these on Amazon. Literally the same one I just got in yesterday. Now I have another one. I didn't even need the one from Amazon, but I hear you have to throw them out every couple months, so I'll just save this one. They also gave me lavender. I'm not sure if this is supposed to be used in the bath or the tea. Maybe I could do both. I'm not sure. This is also a pamphlet on the massage. I will tell you the benefits. Detoxification, which is what I am doing it for, to detox my body, get it ready for surgery, and then you can come back after your surgery and it helps with healing and recovery. So I'm definitely going to go back to them after. It also helps improve skin health and immune support. Overall, it's just super good to go here before and after. I will be going back to this place. They also were just so sweet and so nice, so I would love to go back. I also got a voicemail from Walgreens that my other medicine is in and I did not have time. I had to go to the post office, so I will be picking up my other medicine tomorrow. Tomorrow I'm also gonna go grocery shopping and pick up all the protein I need for this week and for after surgery, so I need to do a lot of grocery shopping. I am now 5 days out and I am feeling really anxious today. I feel really nervous. I feel like it's really kicking in now that I'm doing this. My surgery is next week. I'm just trying to calm down. I bought my sister's flight, so she is coming to stay with me. She will be with me for the first 4 days, so that definitely does make me feel better. She's a nurse, so I feel like my post-surgery won't be that bad. I'm not as nervous for the post-surgery. I think I'm just really nervous to go in there and be put under anesthesia because I've never been put under before. I've never had surgery before, so I'm really nervous for all of that. And then I am nervous to see the size because I don't want it to be too big, but at the same time I don't want it to be too small. So there's a lot of things that are making me nervous. I just keep telling myself that I need to trust the surgeon, that he will know, but it's still just so nervous. I'm thinking like, am I doing the right thing? But all these nerves and anxiety are really normal before. I just need to breathe. It'll be okay. I am going to Target today to pick up all the protein and all the meals that I will need for after. I heard pineapple juice is really good for inflammation, so I'm gonna be picking up lots of pineapple juice. If you know anything else that helps with inflammation, leave it in my comments below. I will get some before my surgery. Hopefully this video will be up before I go into surgery, but we will see. I also booked another appointment. I have heard of hyperbaric oxygen therapy. You go in and you're breathing in different oxygen for an hour, and that's supposed to really help your cells. cells so that after surgery, your cells will be ready to heal itself. So I'm doing that the day before, the night before actually. I just booked that. I'm extra prepared. I know that I will not get sick. I'm not worried about that. So luckily I have some things covered. Really quick, I just wanted to show what I picked up from Target. So this is both vegan chicken and vegan ground beef. I want to make the ground beef with rice and with tofu, and then the chicken I can put in a salad. Here is 3 packs of tofu that I got. I need lots of protein, so the vegan meat and the tofu both have a lot of protein. I got pineapple juice because I heard pineapple juice is really good for inflammation. I got coconut water to hydrate. I got 2 detox shots to help me detox. Sunflower seeds to put in the salad for more protein. I also got a ton of soups because I hear that it's hard to eat an actual meal after surgery, that you should just have liquid. So I got the soup for that. I also got cranberries and nuts to put in the salad along with some protein bars for more protein. And here is 2 packs of romaine lettuce that I got. I have a lot of food. I feel like this will keep me good for after. I am now 2 days away from my surgery, so I'm going to end the vlog here. I hope it was very informative, and if you have any questions at all, please leave it in the comments and I will reply to all of your questions. I will be making another vlog of a few things I'm doing before my surgery, the surgery day, and then how I am healing after, so make sure you stay tuned for that video. And if you are thinking about getting a boob job, I hope this helped so much. Thank you guys so much for watching. Good luck on yours. I know it will go great. Bye guys.